Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. This is Crazy Kitsune Gaming with yet another episode of the Garden Warfare 2 campaign walkthrough. And for some reason, I have an entire company with me. Don't know why, they just decided to hang out. I kind of wish I could bring them into the next level with me. Because now we are doing the corn emissions. And oh my word, like I said, these ones are going to be really, really difficult. This is the one that I would recommend doing absolutely last. You could do the citron and rose in whichever order you prefer, but oh my word, do the corn missions last. Alright then, here we are at Corn's base. It's a nice little base. He actually has, you know, equipment here. Good old corn cob plane. And he has a tractor, okay. I mean, I don't think that's gonna help you in war, but I mean, the Ukrainians use these things to pull tanks off the battlefield and repurpose them, so, hey, maybe there's something in the tractor I'm not seeing, I'm not too sure. But, in any case, hello there, Agent Corn. I salute your bravery, soldier! Well, thank you. Okay, and we'll be switching these to normal, because this mission especially, oh my word. If you've completed this mission on crazy difficulty, then, like, you deserve a salute, seriously. This is a very difficult mission. So, we're going to be going to Z-Tech Factory and track down intel and locate the secret nuke juice shipping routes. Yep, we're looking for that good old nuke juice. Man, that stuff's better than Mountain Dew. I swear down. We need to drop you behind enemy lines, straight into the Z-Tech factory. You must track down intel and locate the secret nuke juice shipping routes. Are you ready to move out? Affirmative. Alright then. Let's get ready for a very, very nasty little mission. So this is a special ops mission, but it's very different than the average one. Usually, each wave takes up a decent chunk of the mission. This one is barely like a garden ops. Basically, you get a scout group. You kill the scout group, and then the entire army comes at you. That's kind of how this mission goes down. And we're going to be doing it as Sunflower, because I figure we're going to be needing to keep our allies alive really, really well. Because they're going to be absorbing tons of damage. Recon says we're clear. Move out, soldier! Okay. Establish a base camp in that laboratory. I'll get right on that as soon as I have a setup I feel comfortable with. Pea shooter, corn. Do we want a citron to soak up damage? We could just go with another corn. Because corn does have, like, slightly above average health. Yeah, I guess we'll go with another corn. I'll be trying to just keep them alive myself. What are you doing, buddy? What strategic value are you seeing in jumping around aimlessly? No, don't you do it too. Now everyone's doing it. Dang it. But anyway, yes, this is the Z-Tech factory. They obviously do a great job cleaning up graffiti, because that is everywhere. Oh my word. I forgot how nasty this space was. It is not kept clean. Alright. Now, interesting thing about Z-Tech Factory is it has these portals you can go through. Now, they are one-way trips. So say I go through the laboratory portal, I now can't go back. I would need to run back all the way to that location where I found the laboratory portal. So keep in mind, once you go through these portals, it's not very easy to get back. Say I went through the armory portal, then I'm now just in the armory and I would need to run my leafy petals all the way back to wherever I actually wanted to be. So, yeah, they're useful if you actually want to get to those rooms, but if you actually plan on getting back soon, just keep that in mind. And they have these little portals everywhere. And they're very efficient for travel. It's just not something that the average player knows that they can't go back. I have seen so many people try to, like, just constantly run all over this thing, assuming that it works like normal portals and they can go back. No, that ain't how it works. You can jump on this thing as much as you want. You're stuck. If you want to go back, you gotta run back. But anyway, let's go ahead and set some stuff up. Now, the good thing is, the first groups are not going to be very threatening. Alright, dig your foxholes. Hold the line. I think you'll find I am very good at finding foxholes. I have no trouble with that. Yeah, we genuinely want to set up a somewhat okay-ish defense. Because we're kind of getting into the business end of the campaign now. Like, they're not gonna go very easy on us. I mean, not that they've really been going easy on us for the past few missions, but, like, now it's going to be especially nasty. Zombie scouts are heading this way. Oh, yes, I'm sure they are. Good thing is, it is a modest little scout group. It's just that nothing after it is very modest. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yeah, they have an archaeologist here. So basically, the archaeologist is kind of like a scientist, except he's able to deal decent damage to you at all ranges. The good thing is, he can't hit you very hard at close range like the average scientist. We also had a aquatic scientist. I forget what the aquatic scientist is called. But basically they're like the average scientist, but like really overtuned. They do way more damage to you at close range than even a regular scientist would. The only saving grace about getting attacked by a marine biologist, I remember their name now, is that they need to spend a lot of time reloading. So if you can catch them in that reload time, then you're probably gonna win. Okay, massive wave is approaching. This is the oh my goodness, yeah, this is the meat and potatoes of the level. We are going to be needing to defend ourselves from copious amounts of zombies for a very long time. Oh my goodness, they're using the portal. They're using the portal! No portal using is allowed. I say that, they're gonna keep doing it anyway. Oh, with imps, give it a break with the imps. Hello there, goodbye. Foot soldier, where are you going? Why are you running? Why are you running? Corn, yes, I know I need to heal you. I'm being really bad about that, I know. Oh, hello. Thanks for dropping in. Oh, yeah, and this is another problem with the level. The AI allies, because there are so many targets absolutely everywhere, don't quite prioritize properly. And it means that you run into the situation where they get so spread out. And yeah, like this. He's just getting his leaves blasted over here. Because he just doesn't really know where else to go because there are so many targets everywhere. And it means that they just split up, your teammates, they split up so often that they go out in onesies and twosies and end up getting themselves killed. Oh dear, okay. I realize I'm doing that as well. I need to be getting back to the base. Do not throw, you literally just threw a rock at me. No. Okay, hello, I see you, flag zombie. Uh-oh, a camo ranger. Yeah, you want to be careful with camo rangers. Their damage isn't very high, but they can consistently deal it to you from basically any range. That is the thing to be watched out at, camo ranger. Best case scenario with a camo ranger is to honestly get directly in their faces. That's honestly the best strategy for dealing with them. Oh, and there's another one. So yeah, here, this is not the ideal situation for camo rangers. You see, they weren't really prepared for that situation because they were just trying to get directly to the garden to try and use something like a ZPG, I bet. But it meant that they were in close range, which is not something the camo ranger does incredibly well with. Hello. Oh, hello. Oh, hello. This is a sunbeam opportunity. I see. Why would you come back here? You were running the other way and then you decided, "Oh yeah, the sunflower over there is using her beam ability. That's the opportune time to attack." Guys, I think you need a lesson in strategy. That's just not how you do things. Okay. We're getting kind of close. But that also probably means they're gonna start bringing out the nasty boys. Hello, everyone. Oh dear, oh, I see a nasty boy. Oh yeah. Super commandos, these are the deadliest foot soldiers, full stop. It doesn't matter where you are, what distance you're at, they can kill you very fast. If you see a super commando, that should always be your top priority. And that's what makes this mission so hard on the crazy difficulty, is most of the foot soldiers then become super commandos. Oh, hello, tank commander. Yeah, you are nowhere near as. Oh my, no, die, die, die. No. Go back to your grave. Go back to your grave. You had no business being out of it in the first place. Yeah, super commandos are so. I mean, look at my health bar. Super Commando helped with where my health is at right now. Because they just deal so much damage. They have this, like, burst attack. It's very deadly. Don't get hit by Super Commandos. It is a very, very good way to get sent to an early grave. That's the outhouse zombie for you. This is this little joke I make about the outhouse zombie. First to spawn in. Last to get into the fight. Okay. So the good thing is we are now done with the main danger of this level. Maybe having corns as DPS around is a good strategy for this level, because usually it goes a lot more difficultly. Those robots have the intel. Eliminate them! Alright. Ah, yes, this is gonna be a. Yep, a robot soldier. Ooh, where is Imps going though? Oh, you're trying to cut off any help from coming to me. That's clever. Okay. Kill 'em, boys! Alright, we have received the secret intel. Now we just need to clean up this scouting party. There we go. Alright. Yeah, kind of an anti. It's a very anticlimactic level. Like, seriously. Hilo is Oscar Mike, alright. So, yeah. That's another level in the bag. How many coins do we get? It better have been a lot. Okay, yeah, like 10,000. That's good. I was thinking it was like 7,500, and then I realized the Wand of Sweet Spells gave more money than that. I'm pretty sure the Wand of Sweet Spells also gave you 10,000 coins. Because that quest is way easier than this one. Like, no offense, just like, that is a difficult little mission there. Although, it is good training for the actual Garden Ops mode, which I should probably do a video on at some point. Because it is a really fun game mode. Like, not even joking around, like, it's a really good game mode. I know because I have over 300 games of it completed. Those are just the ones I completed. I can't even tell you how many of them I've just like disconnected in the middle of. But anyway, that is today's mission. So if you enjoyed the video and found it helpful, then subscribe, like, and maybe even comment, you know, give any helpful tips you have about this level, 'cause it is not an easy one. It's actually the main reason I would recommend doing this playthrough last. This set of missions last. Also, I realized that Korn has a toilet seat beside him. And right above his slushy, no less. Anyway, if you want more useful Plants vs. Zombies facts, like where toilet seats are placed, then see me in the next video. I'm sure I'll have something for you.
Good day.